let's take a look at how you can batch edit all of your coursework due dates in Blackboard. All right, see course content, and I'm gonna go over here to the three horizontal dots. We're gonna click that. I click on batch edit. You click on the modules like this. I click on module 1, 2, 3, 4, and then I go down to here where it says edit dates. Now I have a couple of things I can do. I can change the dates based on like course start. I can change by number of days. I can change to a specific date or time. And you can really do any of these. You just kind of have to have all that kind of calculated and how it's all going to work. So what typically has probably been happening or may happen to you or anyone. Even when I tinkered with this, I was like, hey, what's going on? So I'm going to start with change dates based on course start. All right, when I click on change dates based on course start, I'm going to put this semester, like for spring 2024, we started here January 16th. And the new start date for fall for us here, where I'm at, STC, South Texas College, for fall, we're going to go to August 26th. Ooh, I missed it. Sorry, let me go back here. All right, there's 26. Now, you would think this would work and it'd be all good, but I wish it was that simple. This actually will not work. You can see dates and selected items will move forward 223 days. All right, so when I do that, it's not going to work as we're hoping. I click edit dates. It's going to change it. Let me show you what actually happens when I do that. Now the some dates or times have been successfully updated. Only items with existing values, can be modified. It's just letting you know that anything that, because I just clicked on the modules. So there's other things, of course, in those modules where it's like, hey, there's nothing to change there, basically. So you could go in there and individually select all the assignments if you want, but you're not messing anything up. It's fine. Now, this is not how I'm going to do it in the end, but this is like when you're tinkering and figure out how to do it, this is typically probably what everyone's going to run into where you're just like, hey, I'm going to try a mass change, whether you're weekly, modular, every other week, month, however you do it. And it isn't going to work that way. So let me show you why. So I put the current start date, the new start date, and it's like, okay, cool. It's all going to work. Well, it doesn't work out exactly as we hoped, but let's take a look and see how close it got. So when I look at module 1, the elements of music, I see, 27, 26. Okay, I'm looking for Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. Because the coursework I give is all modular, my module 1 goes from week 2 all the way through week 5. So in week 5, at the end of this module, that's when the work is due on Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. So if I actually double check all that, I can see, okay, cool. Let me look at my notes and I'm double checking. Is this all lining up here? I want to find week 1. I'm looking at, I need 27, 28, and 29. They're actually off by a day. So it should be, the Padlet should be 27. All the journals should be 28. And then should be Sunday the 29th. So I'm off by a day right here. And the reason for that is it's calculating through the 25th, not including the actual start day for the math. So I'm going to head out of here and, well, first I want to fix this. Let me fix it and I'll show you why it's kind of doing that. So I'll do a global setting to basically just to refix this. Okay, I'm going to edit the dates, and then what I'm going to do is just go by number of days, and we're going to shift it backward. Let's go, it's going to be 223. All right, so I've shifted everything back globally. Now I'm going to actually process these separately. I'm going to edit the dates on this, and what I'll do is I'll go to change dates by number of days. I'm going to shift my dates forward 224 days. Blackboard will do it as 2/23 when you actually put the current session or semester start date with the new one. You'll have to add the day. 2/24. Edit dates. It's done. I mean, it's literally just a few seconds. And then if I go up and I want to just verify, then I can see, 27, 28, and 29. Like, everything looks good. My Padlet, my journal, my quiz. And as I'm looking at my notes, I'm like, yep, Friday, September 27th, Saturday, September 28th, Sunday, September 29th. That is awesome. We are golden. And in this case, I see I've got module 3 ready to go. I've got module 4 ready to go. And I'm not worried about any kind of de-clicking or individual clicking. I'm just going to go global. I'm going to edit the dates. And I'm keeping in mind that spring break affects the math. So I'm going to click change dates by number of days. Now, I need to shift the dates forward, but instead of doing 2/24, we just need to subtract from that. So let's go from 2/24. If we put 2/17, I edit the dates, literally just a few seconds, and it's updated. I'm gonna move my notes here a little bit. Got a post-it and some notes. Okay, so I scroll back up. Okay, just double check. All right, making sure I'm clean here, ready to go. All right, I see 11/8, 11/9, 11/10. In this case, our final exam schedule is it's straight up starting on Monday and ends on a Friday. So actually, I have to change it to Friday the 13th. So I'm gonna do that now. I'm just gonna individually select this one, final exam. I'm gonna go to edit dates. On this setting, I'm gonna change to a specific date or time. I'm gonna do due date, due time, or instead of due date time. And we need to go to months. I'm gonna go to December. And we're gonna go to, what is that, 12/12, so 12/13, there we go. Let's fix this time. Everything looks good. And I have it ready to go. And I can see the review time was still aligned. All the planning that you do in your normal course planning for the class, once you have all that down, whether it's on paper or you're looking at your digital notes, your iPad or whatever, then when you come over here to do it, you'll probably be done in like 30 to 60 seconds if you've done all that prep work before. So yeah, yay. All right. Well, that's all I have for now on Blackboard tips and tricks with Professor Ron. We'll see you in the next one. Bye.